content to come. Combined, we're bringing up 7 times elite. So let me walk you through their credentials, and then I'll bring them to the stage, and we're going to jump in and have a real brief, we're going to have a great conversation. How about that? Here we go. Our first presenter that's going to come out is Beachbody coach Amy Rada. She is a seven-star diamond coach, currently 9-star qualifying. She's a 2018 elite coach, end of the year at number 20. She's a Success Club 10 All-Star legend. She's currently ranked number 7 in the entire network. The next speaker we're gonna bring up is Meredith Ganell. Meredith is a 4-time elite coach from San Diego. She's an executive leader on the leadership ladder. Again, 7-star diamond coach, Success Club 10 All-Star legend, and she's currently ranked number 40 in the network. And our final presenter will be Jamie Innes. She's a 2-time elite coach, 7-star diamond coach, 8-star qualifying, executive leader, Success Club 10 All-Star legend, and she's currently number 11 in the network. They're all three currently 7 stars, ironic. Let's welcome to the stage Amy Rada, Jamie Innes, and Meredith Ganell. Okay guys, we're gonna jump into this because we've got a lot of information we want to cover.
How cool is that?
Okay, here's what we're gonna do. Let's start into this. We'll go through couple rounds of everybody and we'll dive specifically into a couple of questions. The first one is tell us, let's start with Meredith and we'll go into why you became a Beachbody coach.
Well, originally when I did contact my coach, and originally it was because I was interested in learning about some way not only to get healthy myself, but to help other people get healthy and coach something, but I wasn't sure what. And quite honestly, when I found out it was Beachbody, I wasn't sure it was for me at first, and we might talk about that. So I won't go too far into it, but I will say the clincher that got me to actually become a coach was that I could earn my investment, my challenge pack back, and I knew it was refundable.
Awesome. Jane.
So I found my coach on Instagram. I turned her down for 6 months in a row. But I became a coach because I was kind of already doing what we as coaches do. I was a personal trainer, group fitness instructor, wellness specialist for 2 corporate companies, and a gym manager. So I was kind of already doing what we do, but I just wasn't helping as many people as I was able to.
Well, I lacked consistency hardcore. So when I was asked to join this opportunity, I was the roller coaster gym rat who would go run 7 miles on the treadmill and then do a few arms and not really feel like that was good. And so when Jamie reached out to me and asked me to be a coach, I really just wanted to do it for myself and prove to myself that I could actually stick to something for 21 days, but pass that and live a life of consistency.
So let's talk about that. Where did your enroller find you, or how did you find them? Why don't we start with you since your enroller is right next to you?
Yeah, sure. What's up, girl? So basically, Jamie reached out to me on an Instagram message, and I at the time had about 400 followers, friends, families. I would do occasional gym selfies just because, again, I needed some motivation for myself to go. And she reached out to me in the messenger, and I didn't even know that was a possibility, so I clicked on it, and I was like, oh, this is kind of weird, but hey, girl. She said how she admired my photo, and ever wondered if, you know, I would be interested in this opportunity, and I politely, but abruptly said no. I was going through a lot in life at that point, and a lot of things already on my plate. She reached out to me again the next month. I politely and a little irritatedly said, no thanks, girl. And the third time she reached out was my breaking point in my health, with my digestive issues and my health and wellness as far as my fitness. And I was just at an all-time low. So her third reach out was actually came at the perfect moment. And that's when I finally decided, yep, I'm gonna do this. So if that doesn't go to show you to just consistently keep following up and reaching out no matter what, because I told her no twice, and thank goodness she asked one more time.
So before we jump to you guys on that, Jamie, why don't you tell the other side of the story? I'd love to hear what you know about that.
Okay, so first, as you can see, you never take a no for an answer. You wait for the good ones and you keep going. I always tell my team, it's not a no, it's just a no right now. And sometimes people are gonna take a couple months, a couple years, it's just gonna take time. But if you know that these people are the ones that you want, or your dream girl, your dream guy, your dream coach, hang on to them. So anyways, I saw Amy just posting on social media, sharing her story. I'm like, oh my gosh, she's so cute. I'm like, you need to be a coach. Like, you need to do this with me. And she's like, okay. I'm like, okay. And then we just kind of sort of became friends a little bit more, but yeah, she turned me down 3 times, and it really wasn't until we became Snapchat friends, which we're not on Snapchat anymore.
And that was just for our dogs, because we snapped each other our dogs back and forth.
So we have puppies that are, they're not puppies anymore, they're huge, but they're about a month apart from each other. So Moose and Max, we were just like, send pictures of our dogs. And I think that's when she realized I wasn't just this creepy person, like, oh my gosh, your dog's really cute. And then, you know, it was our dogs. That's what...
Those are dogs.
So real quick though, you're not in the same town. This is completely found on social media.
Yep, 100% on Instagram. I'm in Michigan, she was in Wisconsin, and just, I kind of stalked her. I was like, she needs to be on my team.
Awesome, awesome. Okay, so let's jump in, Jamie, as to why and how you found your coach.
So my coach is Chelsea Pearson. She's amazing. So I had been talking to her and her boyfriend at the time, Rob, on Instagram, and it's really crazy because when I was working at Snap, I remember checking my email, and Rob was sending me emails, and just like, you should be a coach, you should be doing these things, and I'm like, this guy is sending me like really long emails, this is cool, I'm printing them off. So I would bring those messages home, and I was living at my parents', my mom was like, this is really weird, like, why would a guy be emailing you, you're taken, and I'm like, he's taken too, like, we're just friends. But we just developed a friendship, the three of us, and when I had my moment after my dad went through a massive heart attack, he survived. 5 years later, he's in the best shape of his life. He's my main why, but Rob related to me because he also had gone through a heart attack with his father. So it was just that connection that after the cardiac rehab went through, I was like, I need to help more people. I need more people to be able to help their loved ones not go through what I went through with my dad. And it was just like, one day I just decided I'm ready to sign up. I remember both Rob and Chelsea were like, okay, and Sandy's the one on sale, the challenge pack. I'm like, I want Turbo Fire. And it was the most expensive one, but I'm a Chalene junkie. So I was like, sign me up with that one. And then the rest is history.
Literally didn't know them at all either, met them online.
No, straight up Instagram. And then of course, Chelsea, I mean, I just wanted a part of her energy. She was just this ball of light, and I just wanted to be in her circle.
Awesome. So Meredith, how did you find your coach, or how did they find you?
Yeah, same story really. Is I found my coach on social. I found her on Instagram, and prior to, right around the time I found her, I'd been teaching yoga for a long time and running little wellness workshops, and I was ready to do something bigger. I wanted to take my business online, but I didn't really know how, and I didn't really have a business to take online, so I was somewhere between wanting to find something that helped get me next level, because I had hit my own plateaus, but then also wanting to find something that I could do. So I would go home at the end of a busy day and scroll Instagram and go under hashtags and look for women that were doing the fitness and the health thing online and stalk them and sometimes buy their programs. And my coach just happened to be sharing her very real and very authentic journey of weight loss and muscle gain and just all of these moments in her life of becoming a better version of her. She was working out in her living room, she was working out in her garage, she was sharing little accolades that she would be getting for helping people, and it just sounded really intriguing. And so I actually reached out when she had a call to action for a 60-day challenge along with an opportunity to become a coach.
Awesome. So Jamie, let's jump in. You become a coach, at what point do you decide to build a business?
So I decided when I had a little challenge for my coach, Chelsea. So she had told me, leadership used to be two-star and up, and you used to be able to bring a diamond coach of yours. So she and Rob were both two-star diamonds, so she gave me the challenge that if I were to hit diamond by a certain date, I would be her guest to leadership. So I was like, all right, done, it's on. And then I hit diamond, and also that was the point where I realized, wow, I actually have a team, ready or not, like, it's go time. So my first Beachbody trip was leadership. So that was kind of crazy to start my journey off with such an amazing trip, but I also was there and being surrounded by all of these top coaches who I admired and looked up to so much, I was like, next year I'm gonna earn my spot and I'm gonna bring Steve. And so the year after that I was two-star diamond, brought Steve, and the rest was just history because I was just like, I just needed to see the vision, and that forced me to see the vision just even better than I could have ever imagined.
Awesome. So Amy, when did you become a coach? How long ago?
I became a coach in October of 2015.
Okay, so talk to these guys about what you wish you knew then that you now know.
To tell your inner main girl to shut up. I always self-guessed everything I did, and I really do think that, you know, with all these beautiful people, I remember my first summit sitting here and just being awe, and you know, it, so you get kind of wrapped up in that mindset of, I will never be as good as her, I will never be as successful, she's so much prettier than I am. But that would honestly be my biggest piece of advice is, you know, always repeat to yourself every single morning, if she can do it, I can do it. And then the other thing was not trusting the process. So I wanted to see results quickly, and when they didn't happen, I would get super frustrated, and there were many times where I felt super discouraged and maybe thought this wasn't for me. And I think that's important to hear because there were a couple times where I did kind of feel that I was going to give up and quit and move on. And I'm really happy that I didn't. But that was honestly it. So.
Awesome. So Meredith, when you got started, well, when did you become a coach?
In September of 2013.
Okay, so when you became a coach, what were the activities in the beginning that you thought were the most important? Or I guess that you now know are the most important?
Yeah, well, shockingly, it's the four vital behaviors. It's the things that I did then that I still do. But I would say there was a very intensive focus on inviting and starting new conversations. I mean, this is a relationship marketing business. And so it was very much about sharing my journey and starting to talk with individuals. I shared my journey online on social media. I really posted that I was going to share, I was going to declare that I was doing this challenge and I'd share my 60-day results. And I think really declaring that publicly held me accountable to it. And really just reaching out to more people. I mean, I would, in regular conversation, really organically, throughout the week, as I would see people, I mean, a normal conversation is, you know, hey, Meredith, what's up? How you been? And I would immediately turn that into an opportunity to plant a seed. And I'd say, I've been great. I've actually been doing a 60-day challenge. I feel phenomenal. I'm working with all these individuals that are losing weight. How are you? And it changed the conversation, but the seed would be planted so that later I could circle back around and lay out that harder invite. So really, it was just about laying out those hard invites, talking to a lot of people, being willing to follow up and sharing my journey openly.
Awesome. So, Jamie, how would you answer? What do you think?
I wish I would have been a lot better organization in the very beginning. I had no system, no tracking. I look back now and so many of my people had fallen through the cracks that I will never be in touch with because I had no system. So I just want to tell you guys, whatever it is, try a system and find out one that works, whether it's Teamsy or Streak or High Achievers Playbook or something else. Figure it out now because you're going to really wish you would have had that in the beginning because you're only going to become more and more successful the more consistent you are. But I really wish I would have been more organized from the get-go.
So let's jump into that. Let's have each of you answer, how do you track your follow-ups, your conversations, people you're talking to? What do you do now? How